It's the first day of the Democratic National Convention in Chicago, with thousands of delegates gathering to celebrate presidential nominee Kamala Harris. US President Joe Biden, just one of today's big keynote speakers. Catherine Firkin joins us live from inside the convention. Catherine, the Democrats have been buoyed by a recent surge in support. What's the atmosphere like?
Good afternoon, Neralda. Well, it certainly is an incredible atmosphere here, and this really is a truly historic moment in Chicago. And if you believe the hype in this arena, what we're watching effectively is the handing over of the US presidency from one generation to another, from US President Joe Biden to his Vice President Kamala Harris. Now, President Biden is set to take the stage at any moment. He's not here quite yet, but his appearance will effectively be the grand finale to today's proceedings. He's expected to speak about his pride in leading his party and leading the nation over the past term. And he's also expected to look forward to how the party might evolve under a Harris presidency. He's set to be joined on stage by his family and by Kamala Harris herself. And Harris actually spoke to the convention a little earlier. She thanked the thousands of delegates who've come from right across America to attend this event. And she also summarised her political platform effectively as wanting to make sure that everyone gets a fair go.
Looking out at everyone tonight, I see the beauty of our great nation. People from every corner of our country and every walk of life are here, united by our shared vision for the future of our country. And this November, we will come together and declare with one voice, as one people, we are moving forward. With optimism, hope, and faith, so guided by our love of country, knowing we all have so much more in common than what separates us.
Now, traditionally at conventions like this one, we see the vice president and presidential candidates officially nominated. That's already happened in this case. So instead, the focus here really is on solidifying the Democrats' platform. They're also looking at ways they can potentially beat Donald Trump. And of course, one person who's particularly keen to achieve that goal is Hillary Clinton, given her experiences in 2016. She spoke to the convention and said she feels like Donald Trump is finally on the run. And Neralda, one thing I think that's interesting, that's worth mentioning, is that it's only day one and already we can tell that the Democrats are really trying to paint a very rosy picture of what America might be like if they're in power. And that is in stark contrast to Republicans, who've really been running quite a fear-based campaign, talking about everything that might go wrong if they are not elected. So it's going to be very interesting to see how those two very different messages play with American voters and which really resonates most with the public here.